In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the morning, O Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning, I prepare a sacrifice for you and watch. My mouth is filled with your praise and with your glory all the day. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. A reading for this coming Sunday from Luke chapter 14. Jesus said, "Whoever does not bear his own cross and come after me cannot be my disciple." Also this Sunday we'll be singing the hymn 685, "Let Us Ever Walk with Jesus." The first stanza is, "Let us ever walk with Jesus, follow his example pure, through a world that would deceive us, and to sin our spirits lure. Onward in his footsteps treading, pilgrims here our home above, full of faith and hope and love, let us do the Father's bidding. Faithful Lord, with me abide, I shall follow where you guide." J. Adam Rimbach, pastor of a church in Ashland, Kentucky, learned this hymn when it was sung in German at the Missouri Synod Central District Convention in La Porte, Indiana, in 1900. He taught the hymn to the children in his church's school, and they loved it. But when they sang it for the congregation, many were unable to appreciate it because they did not know the language. So Rimbach produced the translation that has worked its way into our current Lutheran Service Book hymnal. Each stanza of this hymn begins with a statement resolving to imitate Jesus. Justified by his saving work, the believer does not follow Jesus to earn salvation, for Christ has done all that is necessary for our redemption. Rather, in thankfulness and loving obedience, the Christian wants to follow by faith closely in the footsteps of the Savior. The first stanza of the hymn speaks of the desire to walk with Jesus by following his perfect example. Alert to the world that evil forces are that seek to lure us into sin, we are protected on our pilgrimage to heaven by staying close to Jesus, the Good Shepherd. Stanza 2 expresses our willingness to suffer with Jesus and patiently bear the cross he lays upon us. In the upper room, Jesus prepared his disciples for the path that lay ahead. Later, St. Peter comforted persecuted Christians, writing, "Beloved, do not be surprised at the fiery trial when it comes upon you to test you, as though something strange were happening to you. But rejoice insofar as you share Christ's sufferings, that you may also rejoice and be glad when his glory is revealed." 1 Peter 4. In stanza 3, the believer is determined to die with Jesus, since Jesus conquered death. Those who are his by faith will not fall to eternal destruction, but will be given the breath of immortal life. This is baptismal language from Romans 6. Believers die with Jesus confidently, confident that we live with him. And stanza 4 asks us to live with Jesus in the victory of his resurrection. Because he is risen from the dead, we too shall rise. Christ is ahead of his body, the church, and we are living members of that body. Join us this Sunday as we sing this hymn. We pray on Thursdays for the church and her pastors, for teachers, deaconesses, and other church workers, for missionaries and all who serve the church, and for the fruitful use of the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. We also pray this day for Evangeline, who celebrates her birth, Ken and Margie, who celebrate their marriage and life together. And we also pray for those who've asked our prayers, Allegra and Connie, Cindy, Darren, and Deacon, Debbie, Esther, and Ed, Eve and Graham, Irene and Jackson, Jacob, Jerry, and Jim, John, Joshua, and Judy, Justin, Lisa, and Mark, Rachel, Sarah, Sue Ellen, and Tessa, Tim and Walter, Kate, Bill, and Pat, and the family and friends of Patricia, and all who have gone before us. We thank you, our Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you've kept us this night from all harm and danger. And we pray that you would keep us this day also from sin and every evil, that all our doings in life may please you. For into your hands we commend ourselves, our bodies and souls, and all things. Let your holy angel be with us, that the evil foe may have no power over us. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. We go joyfully to our work. We will be streaming again on Sunday morning at 9 a.m., where we join for in-person services at Faith Lutheran Church, 6000 West State Road 46 in Columbus, Indiana.